Hi and welcome to Felicious Reviews, a channel where we talk about all things beauty, which includes makeup, skincare, and sometimes hair care and nails. So if you're interested in any of those, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post, which is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And today I'm talking about the Jouer Essential Lip Enhancer Balm. It's a lip balm from Jouer, and I got this in my BoxyCharm premium subscription box. I think maybe in February. So it's been a while since I've been using it on and off, and I'll get more into it in the application part. This is one of the very few things that I've tried from Jouer, and probably the first thing when it comes to skincare. I'm glad to be trying it and, you know, reviewing it for you guys. And if you want to jump straight to the review portion, you can do so at this time. If not, then keep watching to see a bit of product info, application, and then the review. So this is how it looks, which is pretty much like a lip gloss tube would look like, and it has a similar kind of applicator as well. It comes in around 10 ml of product. And before I get into the application or anything else, let's talk about what this is and what it can potentially do for us. This is supposed to be a refreshing and hydrating lip balm. It is supposed to be a translucent light pink with a soft rose scent. Now I know a lot of you guys might be thinking scent, that must mean that it's heavily scented or something, but I'll get to that in the review part, so hold your horses. It features something called Maxi Lips, which is supposed to reduce the appearance of lines and wrinkles on the lips, as well as creating a full lip look, which is something that even the Laneige Lip Treatment Balm claims to do. If you want to check that out, you can over here. It also has vitamin E to be like a natural conditioner for the lips and give antioxidant benefits. And then shea butter to protect against flakiness of the skin, which I happen to get a lot on my lips. And then jojoba oil, which creates like a protective seal around the skin of your lips to lock in all hydration and moisture and all of that. So it definitely seems like something that is interesting as a lip balm. I feel like a lot of people would be drawn to this product based on its description and everything. So keep watching to see a little bit of application. You can skip the application if you want to altogether and jump straight to the review at the time that I indicated in the intro. So this part is about application and how it's meant to be used and how I like to use it. The brand says that it is a good night treatment, like a leave-on night treatment kind of thing, like a lip mask would be. But I generally use it during the day because at night I'm using either my favorite Sugarish by Tarte Best Bud Lip Butter Balm or the Laneige Lip Treatment Balm. So I would use it during the day when my lips are looking a little bit, you know, grayish, a little lackluster or something. And sometimes I would use it at night when I don't want to stick fingers in my favorite lip balm jar. So I would just pop this on and I would be good for the nighttime routine. This is also a constant in my travels, like in my travel bag and stuff. I keep this because it's much easier to use a balm that's in a tube as compared to the those that are in a jar. So this is a constant in my travel thingies, and I like to use a nice big amount. That almost completely coats my lips until when I'm rubbing my lips together, I feel nothing but lip balm. I don't feel my lip or the crackness or the skin of my lips. As you can see, it's a pretty intense kind of looking application. Again, you don't need to use that much. This is how I prefer my lip balms to be. I like to use heavy coats of lip balm because that's just the way I like it. And that is the end of the application part, and we can go straight to the review now. So now that we know some tidbits about this lip balm, like its product info, as well as how it's meant to be used and how I like to use it and how long I've been using it. Let's jump straight to the review portion of this video, and I'm gonna start this off with lights, which is just first of all packaging. I like that it comes in a lip gloss kind of tube, so that you is and it's not in a jar like a lot of lip balms are, a lot of lip masks are, and you either have to use an applicator or your fingers to apply it. And this, you just don't, you don't have to do anything, you can just directly apply it onto your lips as you saw in the application video. Number two is scent. This has a rose scent, and I absolutely love this scent, and I cannot understand people who do not love rose scents. But if you do, if you're one of those people, then you should know that this is not overly scented at all. It's very, 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 very minimal, kind of like a hint of scent, and you might not even feel it. But again, if this is something that you are sensitive to or allergic to, then you might want to stay away from this product. If you've ever tried, if you've tried the Laneige lip treatment balm, then you should know that this smells nothing like that or even to that intensity, because that is just heavily, heavily scented. And this is like maybe 1/8 of that scent, maybe. Number three is even coat. So the applicator, like I showed you in the application video as well, this is the kind of applicator that it has, and it kind of assures that you're getting a very nice even coat of product on your lips. And I feel like it kind of does suit well to my lips. My lips are very like small and thin, and not every applicator is good for it. So this was actually really nice for my lip shape, which means it can be very nice for any lip shape, because mine are just that pathetic of a shape. The coat that I'm talking about is like, it's so even, and it feels like it really is sealing in moisture and hydration, because it feels much more like a lip mask than it feels like a lip balm or a lip gloss or anything. Number four is the shine I get from this. Now, this isn't a lip gloss by any means, but if you know you want a little bit of a pick-me-up during the day or something, then this is going to be like a really nice natural looking lip gloss. It's not an actual gloss, but it's gonna give you a nice sheen or shine to your lips that's gonna look very natural, and like your lips are really hydrated and moisturized. And number five, it stays on pretty well. It's, I'm not gonna say that it lasts like ages, because it's a lip balm, and lip balms rarely last like hours and hours and hours, but for a lip balm it lasts pretty well. It doesn't come off that easily, like if you are eating or if you're drinking or something, then it's not going to come off completely while you're eating like a lipstick does or like an actual lip gloss does. This is going to stay on quite nicely. Number six is lightweight. I love that this feels like I'm not wearing much on my lips. If you saw the application part, you must have seen the amount of product I used. And I have to say that even if you're wearing like layers upon layers of this product, you're not going to feel much on your lips. It's not going to feel heavy at all. Number seven, less is more with this product. Now, just because I use the amount that I do doesn't mean that you have to too. If you are more like a minimal kind of person, which I'm not when it comes to lip balms, this is going to be a nice addition for you. Why? Because a little bit of an amount goes a very long way with this, especially because it can, this applicator, this tip can spread the product very nice and very evenly, so you don't have to keep on pushing out for product. So my point is that it does not take a lot of product to do its job like it's meant to. Again, if you want to use more, you can use more, but you don't have to, just because I do. Number eight is results. My lips or my lip skin feel really nice and soft and smooth afterwards. Even right now, like I have it on right now, and my lips feel quite plump and smooth. I don't feel my dryness at all, which is what I want from my lips. I do not want to feel the crackiness or the you know, flakiness of my lips at all when I'm using a lip balm or even lip product. And I don't feel it with that either. So I feel like this can actually be a really nice lip primer, if that makes sense. Like if you want to put on lipstick but your lips are really, really dry or something, you can put this on underneath that lipstick and it's going to look amazing. It's going to be like a lip conditioner prior to using your lipstick. And this is the end to my list of likes. Now let's talk about my dislikes, which are just two. First of all is that it does not offer any exfoliation to my lips. When it says that it has shea butter to protect your skin from flakiness, it doesn't mean that it's going to remove the flakiness you already have on your lips. It means that it's going to prevent it from getting flaky. So there's a fine line over here. There's a technicality over here. So if you have very dry lips or chapped lips, this isn't going to help you much because it's not going to exfoliate your lips, which is what you would need probably. So what I would suggest is don't use a lip scrub because that's going to be really harsh on your lips. What I suggest instead is to try a lip balm that has exfoliants in it. And by exfoliants, I don't mean physical exfoliants like scrubs or like microbeads or something, but chemical exfoliants like AHAs or lactic acid. So if you try my personal favorite, which is the Sugar Rush Best Bud Lip Butter Balm, that also has a lactic acid in it, which offers mild exfoliation. So it's actually actively working on your lips to remove the flakiness that you already have, as well as protecting it from future flakiness or whatever. And the same goes with the Laneige Lip Treatment Balm. That's not my personal favorite, but those are separate reasons. You can see that in that video why. But basically, that is my point, that if it's supposed to protect against flakiness, it should also fight the flakiness that we already have on our lips. Which brings me to number two, temporary results. Now, when I mentioned results in my likes, I did mean that, of course, but I meant that if those results are existing or there as long as I have the lip balm on my lips and very shortly after I remove it. So if I remove it right now, they're gonna stay smooth for maybe 15 to 20 minutes, but then after that they're gonna go back to how they were prior to using a lip balm, which is not great because you want a lip balm which is doing something to your lips that is working to improve your lips, you know, kind of like a serum does. You know, you're using consistently, but it actually does give you consistent results as well, long-term results. For example, a vitamin C serum, you're using that every single day and you're noticing a brightness in your skin even if you are not using that serum for that particular time of the day, if that makes any sense. So the same goes over here, is because if it has no exfoliant, so it's not doing much to your lips in the long term. It is conditioning them for a while, but that condition, of course, it goes away when the lip balm goes away. And the lip balm is not there, it's not protecting anymore from their dryness or flakiness, so it does get dry and flaky. So, which is why I again recommend to get a lip balm that has exfoliants in it, because those are going to actually give you results that are long term. I would not use this at night, especially because I feel like leaving on an effective product overnight is going to be much more beneficial for you than using, you know, ordinary lip balms like this. So that is the end of my likes and dislikes. You can get this product at Sephora for $17, which is a good price for a high-end brand, but will I be purchasing it? Probably not. Why? I mentioned that in my dislike, but yeah, that's the only reason that I would not purchase it, and I would not recommend this to anybody who is actively trying to make their lips feel less dry or less flaky. But if you don't really have any problems with your lips, lucky you, then this is going to be a good lip balm for just like a pick-me-up, a little bit of gloss, a little bit of like, you know, extra oomph to your look. I will recommend this not as a lip balm or a lip mask, but as an actual like a plain lip conditioner or a lip primer or a lip gloss, like a mild lip gloss or something. So that's how I would recommend it as. I would not say that this is going to help your skin in any way. It's going to make you look temporarily good, like a makeup primer does. And if you want a recommendation for a good lip balm, then try the Sugar Rush by Tarte Best Bud Lip Butter Balm. If you are looking to shop on a tight budget, that comes in at $12. You can find that on Ulta Beauty. Or Laneige Lip Treatment Balm, that comes at $25, but it has a strong scent. So if you can get over that, that's a good one, and you can find that on Sephora. So now let's talk about my rating breakdown. And first of all is performance. I'm gonna give it a 0.75 because even though it looks good and my lips feel good at the time, the results are quite temporary. Number two is price. I'm gonna give it a 0.75 because even though it is a good price for a lip balm, especially a high-end lip balm, I don't think it is fully worth its price because it's not actually helping your lips in a long-term way. And number three is longevity and convenience, which deserves a whole point because it's really easy to use and it's gonna last you a long time. Because I've been using this for around 2 months on and off, like here and there, not every single day, maybe 2 or 3 times a week or something, and it's still here. Number four is recommendation and repurchase, and I'm gonna give it a 0.25 out of a whole point, and I think I explained myself really well. I don't need to do it again. And number five is special features, which deserves a 0.75 just because it does not have exfoliants in it. Otherwise, I love the scent, the amount of scent, the applicator tip, and you know, the shine and everything else basically I love about it. So that brings my total Felicia score to a 3.5 out of a 5, which means it's an above average product. It's not the best because it isn't the best. It's not doing the best possible job for you. Let's just leave it at that. So I do like this as a lip gloss or a lip primer, but do I like it as a lip balm? Maybe not so much. Maybe not so much. If you have tried this before, let me know in the comments what your thoughts are on this. And let me know what your favorite lip balm is and what you do for your lips to prevent them from flaking and drying. But that is it for me today. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me. Stay tuned for my next video where I'm going to review Merit Beauty Flush Balm Blush. Or stick around and watch one of my older videos.